just believe. Just breathe.
Backstage here with Sabelle, first show of Air New Zealand Fashion Week, day one. How are you feeling?
Feel great now.
Excellent. Yeah.
Well, it's your first show post baby, so was it more stressful this year? Or was like, what, did you have different sort of like vibes going on?
Definitely not any more stress caused by the baby, no. Yeah. No, okay, she's good. Pretty good actually. Yeah.
I saw her this morning in the Mac and Jay show, she's just chilling
she's
on the lockers.
Really chilled out, yeah.
Now, it was an amazing collection. There was lots of paneling and draping and beautiful colours and lilies. Can you sort of describe the whole feeling behind the collection?
Oh, to sum it up. the easiest sort of reference point is the Victorian mm-hmm. idea. And so within that sort of encapsulates lots of different sort of ideas. Yeah. The Victorian sort of explorer and traveller journeys.
Mm-hmm. Is that all the capes and stuff?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, just sort of that feeling. Mm-hmm. And the whole idea, you know, the Victorians explored the world and colonise lots of areas. It's sort of that slight period feel, but then
with your style sort of stamped on top of it. Because you had the beautiful, because you're known for your prints, there was the lily prints, and you had the amazing glass necklaces.
Yeah, they're handmade, all individually handmade and cast in glass by a friend of mine who's also an incredible glass artist who's exhibits her work around the world, and yeah, she's
it's
just
completely
amazing.
Crazy. It was beautiful. And so I heard over here before that the tulips, that was sort of the inspiration behind the some of the dresses and everything.
Yeah, there's sort of paneling that sort of ties back in with the print with some of the same
so
forms.
I was thinking butterfly because of the beautiful backdrop, but then obviously tulip. Now, there was, I called it myself, the naked dress. Look at that, on that beautiful girl, and you just went into her. Do you just like, I want something sexy in there, or...?
It's just a bit of a feeling, like sort of a juxtaposition of innocence and not so innocent.
A bit of naughtiness. Well, it's absolutely beautiful. Congratulations, and you kicked off the week fantastically. Now, Frontrowdiary TV is here backstage at the Juliet Hogan and 27 Names show, and we're going to talk to Jo from Mac about the look that she's creating for this group show. So what have we got going on here?
So what we have is a really beautiful creamy skin. Mm-hmm. Juliet always loves really thick eyeliner, mm-hmm. so we're also going to do double lashes.
Yep.
And the inspiration for the makeup was a bookish beauty with a crimson edge. Yep.
So bookish beauty? What does that really mean?
I think what it means is it's something quite classic, but still really quite, it has a little bit of a different edge to it.
Mm. So strong brow and everything.
Strong brow, a really strong eyeliner, but really creamy skin. So the focus is more on the upper edge of the eye and the face. A really beautiful high contour and just really bringing out the highlighted areas of the cheek there.
Beautiful model high cheekbones of theirs.
I know, which we all wish we could have.
Oh, I know. Now, what if people want to recreate this sort of look at home, what are you using?
I'm using MAC Boot Black Liquid Liner, which really creates a sharp edge. Have you used that?
I use it every day on my eyes.
Amazing, yeah. The best way to get a really sharp, dark matte look. Lingering brow pencil, always filling in the brows, makes a huge difference as well. A sculpting powder works amazing too if you're wanting to bring out the cheekbone. We're also using Lip Erase on the cheek with Vegas Vault lipstick.
Oh, beautiful.
Which is our favorite.
Yeah. Cool.
So yeah.
Beautiful. Okay, well thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you.
Now, Juliet, show's over. How do you think it all went?
Who knows? I think it went okay. We haven't seen the show, obviously.
Well, it looked freaking amazing from out there. I absolutely adored it. Best music of the whole entire week. Well, I know it's day one, but I'm pretty much going to proclaim it as the best music for the whole week.
Anna.
Both of you guys. Now, what was the whole vibe behind the show this week?
The vibe behind the show, it was kind of an evolution from the summer collection, which was called some other time. It's all kind of the same, a little bit retro, a little bit vintage, kind of inspired by like a bookish beauty this time, you know, someone that spends a bit of time in the radio in the library or likes reading and kind of, you know, but who knows.
And it was called So Pretty It Hurts,
so
right?
So Pretty It Hurts, yeah.
I love that. So Pretty It Hurts. Now, what was your favourite pieces from the collection?
Love the lavender cape that opened the collection, and love all the stitched shoulder detail that was, if you could see, on quite a few other pieces.
Now, there were shorter hemlines this year. They were so short, but they were awesome short. I like them. Are you going to keep them that way?
It's a recession. You can't afford lots of fabric at the moment.
I love it. I absolutely love it. And then you've got the must-have item from this summer collection, the long pleated skirt, and then in a dress form.
And the Diana dress, which is just gorgeous.
It's so beautiful and floaty. Now, pleating is obviously your thing. Do you think you're always going to stick around with pleating?
I don't know. I think it's good to, like, each season I try and do something a little bit different with the pleating. So as long as I'm able to do that with each season, I'd like to, because it works really well for me. But I also don't want to be pigeonholed as, like, a Sunray pleaterist.
No. Now, there was quite a lot of, I've noticed on the catwalk, so there's been quite a lot of capes. But your cape was particularly beautiful, the big pussycat bow.
Yeah.
The pink one, in fact, is just walking past
us. The coral one, stunning.
Really gorgeous.
So is it meant to be worn as a cape over a dress or as a whole outfit?
Oh, I don't know. However you want to wear it, really. I imagine I'm wearing it over little dresses and tights in winter. Or, you know, jeans and a tank.
Yeah.
Which is what I wear all the time.
My favourite piece, I think, was the dress that has the actual cape. Is that attached with the arms at the back that Dara is wearing?
So it's all stitched together in at the neckline.
Oh, it's absolutely beautiful. Yeah. Well done. Very clever, Juliet.
Thank you so much. Not a problem. Thank you.
Now we are here with a fantastic duo, Angeline Rachel. Now you won the Runway to Runway Award last night.
Yeah, we were so stoked. We had no idea at all that we were going to win. We're like, there's just no chance. There's just no chance.
Really, really hoping for it.
And all of our friends were like, oh no, but your video is the best. It's like, well, you have to say that.
I have to say it was the best. You put a lot more effort into it.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was really fun, and we were just so ecstatic when we won.
So it's 10 grand of travel.
Yeah.
And where are you going to go to first?
Well, we kind of decided that we would each choose a main place that we wanted to go to, and I want to go to Japan, and then the rest is up to Rachel.
And I'm totally undecided yet. It's like the world is our oyster. It seems like
totally.
So much.
Yeah, traveling. You could, but then you could like spend the whole lot, just go first class. But
yeah, no way, no way.
You want a couple more trips out of it?
Make it like last as long as possible.
Yeah. Now I have to say, I said to Juliet before that your guys' group show had the best music so far. I know it's day one, but I think it's pretty much going to stay that title the whole time. I love it. I was telling Rumi Neely from Fashion Toast, I was like, they always do this great hip hop, and it like came in halfway through. I'm like, yes, it's brilliant. Who chose tracks?
Me and my boyfriend Josh chose them, and we just listened to all these songs on Groove Shark, and we just wanted to combine a couple of different ideas, but it's like quite hard because sometimes banging club tracks don't make good for the runway, and sometimes they do, so you've just got to
take a bit. It works so well. Everyone sat there and looked at each other and smiled and started like tapping their feet.
And especially because we have a reputation to uphold now, so it's always like that pressure of taking it to the next level.
You've got
to have some
sort of hip hop in there, a bit of gangster rap. Now, talk us through the collection. What was the vibe behind it?
We were kind of thinking about the 60s and the Beatles and the mods, and we looked at John and Yoko as like a really awesome style icon couple. And so we've got like a bit of military jackets in there, but we had awesome hats and heaps of lace and
Oh, the knitted, like, we've got to get moved. Knitted bodysuits.
My mum. Yeah. My mum knitted that, and her partner knitted the cardigans, and I just really
was so thrilled
they did them, because I think they just added
The knitting
awesome
was really cool, so chunky.
Yeah.
Are you going to sell the cardigans?
Yeah, we'll hopefully.
Them, but they're going to be quite expensive because the wool's a lot, and they're hand knitted. So if people are excited about the price point, then we'll definitely make them.
Yeah. You might have to just be special orders.
Yeah.
Well, I'll definitely be ordering them. Thanks, girls. Thanks, well done. It was fantastic.
Thanks, Anna.